In the vibrant world of Brisbane's progressive metal scene, one name stands out: Caligula's Horse. Since their inception in 2011, they've not only captivated audiences across Australia, but also garnered international attention. With previous releases gaining recognition on the ARIA charts, the band has now unleashed their sixth studio album, Charcoal Grace. Recently, members Jim, Josh and Dale took a moment to sit down with Heavy to discuss the album and their upcoming East Coast tour. I'm Ez, and you're tuned in to the Heavy Podcast. Join me as I dive into a conversation with the legendary talents of Caligula's Horse. It's a full house in here. This is exciting.
It is.
I wasn't told. I was just like, am I going to get one member? Am I going to get all members? What am I going to get?
You get the worst members. You get all three of the worst members.
Yeah, you've got... Is if there was like a meat and potatoes of Caligula's Horse, you have the potatoes.
As someone who constantly refers to themselves as a potato, I am part of the club now.
One of us.
Yes. One of us.
Let the potato rest for 5 minutes.
So what? Yes. What is your favorite kind of potato?
Oh, look, here's the thing. It's for me, it is a crisp baked potato, but it's been treated well. Okay, you've got to parboil the shit. You got to sort of rough up the edges a little bit, give it a bit of the crunch. You know what I'm saying?
And what do you what do you add to said baked potato? That is also
what do
important.
I add to it?
Yeah,
my mouth.
Your mouth. Oh, so you just bake the potato and that's it? You're not like no sour cream, no bacon, and none of that.
No, Jim hasn't got time for that, man. He throws it in the oven, he goes.
Erin, we're in a progressive metal band, mate. Do you think I'm made of money? Do you think
This is off to a good start, and considering I've only got 10 minutes with you guys tonight, you know, why not talk about potatoes straight
we'll
up?
We'll behave.
Last time.
The correct answer is roast potatoes won't have anything. Next question. Let's go.
Okay, done.
Sick. Well, anyway, thank you all so much for joining me tonight on the Heavy Podcast. Exciting times for Caligula's Horse. You got new music, you got a tour announcement, and just for listeners that aren't in the know, you guys are releasing your sixth studio album on January 26th. It is the sixth, isn't it?
It is the sixth.
Sweet, I did my job properly. And you guys have already given us a taste of what's to come with two singles released recently. I saw your post on social media when The World Breathes With Me was released, and I really love that small blurb that you posted about the theme of the song. Do you mind expanding on that for listeners?
Yeah, sure. This one's kind of like, if there was kind of a snapshot of the themes of the album, I feel like The World Breathes With Me is that, because Charcoal Grace is essentially like a, you know, it's full of motifs and stories of things that we experienced or saw during the pandemic, things that we learned from it. And then some of that is fictional and some of it is deeply personal.
Mm-hmm.
But The World Breathes With Me is kind of a zoomed out view of that. So it's sort of taking the whole journey from the like the loss and utter despondence and the loss of faith in humanity at the beginning of it, and the kind of bitterness of that, through to kind of like understanding that we carry this weight together, and that, you know, I'm as guilty of selfishness as everyone else in our own ways. And then finally realizing at the end that it's, you know, the positive takeaway is that it's, you know, we're all like irrevocably connected by breath, if nothing else, you know, and sort of we're connected to the world through each other. And that kind of journey is essentially what we've been on, because, you know, during the COVID years, we didn't want to do this anymore. I didn't want to write anymore. I had nothing left to say, you know, I was afraid that was going to be forever, and coming back and having that realization as a group has kind of led us to Charcoal Grace as a whole.
One of the things that I love about The World Breathes With Me is that was just a power phrase that I think you chucked out at one point as well. I breathe and the world breathes with me.
Yeah.
And that was like the origins of a very simple idea, I think, at the beginning.
That's so cool. And sometimes the simplest of ideas are the ones that like are born into much bigger monsters, I suppose.
Yeah, the ones where, you know, like I'm trying to write something, or I'm trying to sleep, actually. Usually I'm trying to sleep and then I have to go and write something because the idea is there and I have to go and do it, which is so unfortunate. But yeah, it was one of those.
Yeah, and don't ever fall into that trap of thinking that you'll remember it in the morning.
Yeah, no, get a pen.
Yeah.
Get a pen or convince yourself it's not a very good idea.
Jim's memory is already rotten.
Yeah.
No, I think it's a really beautiful song and such a great sort of snapshot of what a fantastic progressive metal song should be.
Thank you.
Like it takes you on a bit of a journey. So is Charcoal Grace then, is it a concept album or like you said, just a selection of snapshots about a specific time period?
I would say it's not necessarily a concept album. I sort of back and forth over this one, and Sam doesn't think it is, and for a bit I did, but it doesn't fucking matter. There are definitely, like, Charcoal Grace, the four-part suite in the center of the entire thing is fundamentally a concept song because, you know, it's characters and story as well as motifs and themes that carry through everything else. But because of the really deeply honest and personal nature of the other songs, I would say that it's basically an album that's just a collection of themes.
Mm-hmm. I think we've ummed and ahed about that a couple times over the, like, going, yeah, it's a concept album. And then we're like, the more we think about it, we're like,
nah.
Perhaps you can call it a concept album, but each song stands alone.
Yeah,
sure.
Just as well. Nah.
That's great. You can write maybe, you write all the ad copy for this, and and that's fine for me.
Okay. Oh, just put it on the pile with all the other ones. So, Do you have any more singles coming out before the album actually drops?
Yeah, we do.
Hell yeah.
We in very early January, we're going to be dropping single number 3, which is The Storm Chaser. I went blank there for a second, not because I forgot the name of the song, but I forgot where I was. So it's much worse. It's much worse than it seemed.
Do you know, the thing is, you didn't have to say it. I could so edit that just to make it sound so seamless.
Oh, brilliant.
No, never edit. Always candid. We've got the third one there. It's going to be the last little exciting little tidbit before the album comes out. And then kaboom, January 26th. There it is.
Yeah, sick. And then you've got an East Coast tour that you've just announced, which is happening off the back of like a ton of overseas dates as well. So 2024 is already looking like stacked for you guys.
Yes, it is. Josh.
Yeah. Lots of time.
Are you ready to get fat with me in America, dude?
Oh my God, we're in a lot of trouble. You and me, baby.
We are in
a lot of trouble. Oh, it's all the high fructose corn syrup that I'm likely to consume without realizing it or knowingly doing it.
Yeah.
I really am going to eat my way around the country and hopefully burn it off at the shows. Otherwise, yeah, I'm coming back a different person.
What's actually kind of funny about that is that, like, while it's a very silly thing to say, it kind of does reflect kind of the nature of what we love to do when we're touring that we haven't been able to do for so long. And that is that, like, you know, we're a bunch of nerds who like to travel, and yes, we play a lot of shows, and yes, we don't have a lot of time, but with the time that we do have to spend, we like to do it doing cultural stuff or like walking around and seeing what it's like to be in a place.
Yeah.
Sometimes do a little tourism, but a lot of the time it's food and it's, you know, just like being in a location. So, yeah, we're all really excited about that.
I guess people don't understand either that touring schedules are so hectic. Sometimes you don't get the chance to really do the tourist thing. So I guess the next closest thing you can do to experiencing a culture is food.
It's just stick it in your gob. Just eat it.
That's going to be the headline for this interview. Stick it in your gob.
Charcoal Grace 2024.
The subtitle for this podcast is "Can I Eat This?"
Well, I do want to say as well on behalf of Aussie Heavy fans, thank you for bringing Wheel on board for this tour as well, because they are such an underrated band, and I cannot wait to see them. Thanks to you.
Yeah, so. We haven't had a chance to see them live either. Like we've met the lads online, but yeah.
Oh, you haven't? I was going to ask, have you performed with them before or anything like that? But no,
we've had digital contact. I yearn to touch them.
We've eaten hot sauce with them. That's about it.
Yeah, that's about it. But it's cool to have an international band here in support and to have that like really strong package going around. I think people are pretty amped. As you are about bringing Whittle along as well. I think it's going to be really exciting. And
will you have any local supports on as well? Or
I don't think so. I think that the package is just the two bands. Dale, am I right about that, buddy?
It's up in the air. We
sick.
Oh well, I think just having the two is just exciting enough. So
oh yeah,
Yeah. And I did want to say, while we're still talking about food, and this is completely not to do, like, not going to be in the interview at all, I will edit it out, but I can't look at your band name anymore without, because I'm friends with Chris the Malco, and now I cannot look at your band name without the meme that he made of Caligula's sauce.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you can thank him for ruining your band name.
And it's not even like a good, it's a Master Foods tomato sauce bot. You know what I mean?
You mean the greatest sauce in existence.
Take your baked potato.
Oh, dear.
How have we not monetized this into a hot sauce, Jim? What the fuck are you doing with your time?
Yeah, 100%. Right. Do it. Do it.
Boys.
Actually, I'm keeping that in now. If someone wants to get on board and help, like, fund this,
please.
It's time to start experimenting with some recipes, boys. I'll see you soon.
Yeah. Let's make it pepper X. Let's go.
Stick it on a baked potato.
In your gob.
I just had a mouthful of beer and that almost spat it out.
I think that that is a really good note to end on, since our time is already up. That was that felt like it went so quick.
Oh, Erin was sorry.
Oh, that's okay. I know you've got a bunch of interviews to do, so.
No, that's, you know, this has been the most fun. If I laugh more than I actually speak in an interview, that's generally a sign that it's a good one.
Yeah, we covered all of the big topics, of course.
We did it. Home runs.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thanks.
Smash out another interview.
Get them done.
We'll see you in Melbourne in February.
Hell yeah.
February? No, not February. When is it? April.
April.
We were so ready to go. Yeah.
Can you please get me there?
Just come down in February anyway. No, you guys will be overseas.
Yeah, we'll be in the States, man. I can't. I'm sorry. I can't attend.
Alrighty, I better let you get to your next
one.
Awesome,
thanks, Erin. Thanks,
Erin. Alright, see ya. Bye.
Thanks, Erin.
Okay, so what did we learn from this eye-opening conversation? Something about an album and lots of rambling about potatoes and hot sauce. The newest release by Caligula's Horse is titled Charcoal Grace, and it's out now, waiting for you to listen to it in its entirety. The band will be on tour in April, playing the following dates and venues: Thursday, April 25 at Max Watts in Melbourne, Friday, April 26 at the Manning Bar in Sydney, and Saturday, April 27 at the Triffid in Brisbane. As mentioned, prog metal band Wheel, hailing from Helsinki, Finland, will be supporting the boys on those dates. Their first time playing in Australia, so these are definitely shows not to be missed. This has been another episode of The Heavy Podcast. Until next time, keep life heavy.